We teach kindergarten at Veterans Elementary School. The lesson you're about to see is a part of our nonfiction text feature unit that we have been working on for 4 weeks. We started planning for this unit by looking at our data, our Common Core standards, and collaborating with the first grade team. With working in first grade, we identified our priorities that we needed to focus on for the end of the year. We realized we needed to expose our students to more nonfiction text and using text-based evidence.
And we are going to go back in the book, okay? You're going to work with your partner, and you're going to be locating the nonfiction text features that we find in the story, okay? You're going to do that by using your highlighter, and you're going to highlight important nonfiction text features. And then we're going to use our chart to identify the different text features that we found in the story, the text features that the author uses. And I would like for you to put a check mark if you found it in the story. And then you're going to write what page you found it on. And it's okay if you find more than one of each text feature in the story. You can go ahead and write each page that you found the text features on your chart. Now, are we going to find all of the nonfiction text features in our story? Raise your hand. Colin?
No.
The author doesn't always include all of the nonfiction text features.
We identified that we wanted to work with Common Core Informative Text Standard number 6, which was the purpose of the author and the illustrator with those texts. And it integrated with our standard number 9, which was to identify similarities and differences between two texts on the same topic.
We just used our informational text and our text features checklist to find what text features our book, Summer Olympic Events, has. And remember our goal today. Our goal is, how do text features help me better understand informational text? So what we're going to do is, I'm going to call you up with your partner. So I'm going to draw your name out of the cup. The glossary, okay? Delaney, tell us about how the glossary helps us. Yes, it helps you with the boldface words, and it helps you figure out what those boldface words mean.
I wanted to share the captions.
Okay. Erin, can you show us an example of captions? And while you're looking for that, Joshua, can you tell us what a caption does? How does it help a reader?
It's a picture.
Mm-hmm.
Of something labeled.
Okay, it has a picture and there's labels. Do you want to add to that, Erin?
It's a sentence that is under the picture that is smaller, that tells you a little bit more information.
It tells you a little bit more information about the picture. You guys did a great job on that together. If we want to find a boldface word's meaning, where can we look, everyone?
Glossary!
The glossary!
In this video clip, you will see my students picking a text feature and writing about the text feature and how it helps them better understand the information that they're reading.
And we're going to be writing about our favorite text feature. So think about a text feature that you know a lot about, and I will give you a sentence starter on the board, and we're going to write about that text feature and how it helps you as a reader. They're all on our text features poster. Helps me because. Remember to tell me why and how it helps you better understand the text that you read.
We started planning this process with the backward planning. So we developed assessments, performance tasks, and we sequenced our lessons.